All right, y'all. So this is the look that I'm doing today. I'm gonna call this look Green with Envy. I just love the dark greenness of it all, and you know, plus fall is here, and I'm just so excited for fall makeup. But I'm priming my eyes with my crayon case, eye glue stick, and that's my favorite primer right now. And the palette I'm using is my Juvia's Place Magic Mini Palette, and I'm taking that light brown color and I'm just placing that into my crease just to help the dark green and blue eyeshadows blend out. And for my outer corner, I'm taking that dark blue using a short bristle eyeshadow blending brush. And the shape I'm doing this eyeshadow in is kind of like a cat eye shape. So I'm taking the eyeshadow out further than my eye stops. So I'm just patting it on first, and then once I get to the edges, I do want to use like circular motions and patting motions just to kind of blend everything out. And then once I finish with that, I'm just going to take a clean blending brush, and I'm just going to, you know, go back and forth and blend out the edges, and then go back into that blue just to intensify that outer corner. That blue popped so well on that base. I'm telling you, it's like the absolute truth. So I'm taking this forest green color on a flat eyeshadow brush, and I'm placing that right in the center of my eye, taking that up to my crease. And it's a really pretty color, and it's really going to help merge that dark blue into that silver color. So I just really like that color along with that blue. And then taking that clean blending brush that I used before and blend out the edges on the top. And now I'm just taking this color here. I don't have the palette in front of me, but I will put the names of the eyeshadows down below. But I'm taking that silvery shade and placing that on my inner corner of my eye. And I'm just going to kind of go in between the silver and the forest green that we put in the middle, just to kind of blend everything in together. Now for my base, I already have my foundation on, and I believe I used my Maybelline Fit Me foundation. And for my concealer, I am in love with this concealer. This is my Wet n Wild concealer in Dark Cocoa. I've been using this concealer like crazy lately. It's my favorite concealer right now. But I'm just putting it under my eyes, on my nose, on my upper lip, just to keep me from looking like I have a mustache, and blending it out with my beauty sponge. And I really like this concealer because it blends out really nice, but I feel like it does a good job at covering too. And it's only like, what, $3 or $4? I want to say like $3.99. Really good concealer. I definitely recommend it. But I'm just blending that out under my eyes and blending all that out. And as you can see on the left side of the screen, I could have blended that out a little bit further on the bottom, but it was okay. I didn't go anywhere. But setting my under eyes with my Fit Me concealer in Deep 35 and setting the rest of my face with my Dark 40 powder. So I'm just pressing it under my eyes, and I really like this powder as well. Just setting all of that concealer. One of my favorite powders right now, like period. Not even just drugstore. It's just one of my favorite powders right now. It might, period. It's a really good powder. So I'm highlighting my face using my Crown of My Canopy highlighter from Wet n Wild, using my 501 blending brush. Well, highlighter brush from Morphe. And I'm just placing that on the high points of my cheeks. I don't highlight my nose like I used to. I just don't really like how it looks on me, so I just highlight my cheeks. But for my lips, I'm taking this really pretty dark green lipstick from MAC in the color Young Attitude. I love this lipstick so much. It is just so pretty. It's a really dark forest green, and I just love the way it look on my skin tone. And I'm not using a lip liner. I'm just using an applicator just to clean everything up and, you know, smooth everything out. And it's a really pretty lipstick. I love it, and it's that time of the year for it too, so I am ready. So I'm gonna take that it's a small tapered blending brush, and I'm taking that silvery shade. It's lighter than the one that I put on the inner corner, and I'm just gonna pop the that right on the inner highlights of my eyes just to brighten everything up. I knew I should have put something on the bottom, but like I said I wasn't going anywhere. But anyway, this is the look. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. If you decide to recreate it, tag me on Instagram. Thank you for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye.